Well, hi, everybody. Oh, let me try that again. Good morning. Oh, you cool. Here, this is what I'm seeing up here. Look, this is what you guys look like to me. See? Say good morning to the world. Hi, guys. Well, I am so excited to be here in North Carolina, all the way from my home, my art studio, in Houston, Texas. And I want to thank Mrs. Horn for all her work and diligence and invited me all the way up. Thank you, Mrs. Horn. So I get you guys to draw. We're going to draw in 3D. Someone go, whoa. And we're going to draw for over 7 hours straight. No, we're going to draw for about an hour. Your teachers are going, yeah. We're going to draw for almost a whole hour. How many of you love to draw? Raise your hand if you love to draw. Oh, yeah. Good answer. Raise your hand if you're super smart. Okay, put your pencils down so we'll poke your eyeball. Okay, raise your hand if you are raising your hand without a pencil. Okay, raise your hand if you're super smart. Raise your hand if you're probably the smartest person you've ever met. Yeah. Raise your hand if you have a nice hairstyle. Yeah. Take your hand and go, ooh la la. Yeah. Look at Mr. Brown and Mr. Aaron up there. They're going like that. Hello. You can't see them. They're up there giving me all kinds of heckling. They're heckling me. Raise your hand if you are tired of raising your hand. You want to draw. Well, let me introduce myself. My name is Mr. Mark. Say, hi, Mr. Mark. And we're going to be drawing a lot of pictures today. Some of these pictures are the same pictures that I taught for 40 years I've been teaching drawing. And some of the artists that I have taught how to draw, some of the kids, you know, when they were growing up and drawing, they went on and they pursued their passion for drawing. Some of my students worked on movies and animation like Lucasfilm's Star Wars, Despicable Me. Do you recognize that character? Yeah, hola. Some of my past students from years back, they grew up and became animators. Anybody recognize? Oh, that's the fishies. I had one. Oh, look at the little teddy bear. Look. So who knows? So today, oh, do you guys recognize this character right here? Who's that character? See? Some of my students worked on Kung Fu Panda and created the company Pixar and Nemo. So today, we're gonna explore pencil possibilities. Okay, now this is what I see this right here. I call this pencil power. Pencil power. Look at my high-tech animation. Are you totally impressed? Okay, ready? Someone say, pencil power. See, this is you, and you're taking off with your pencil power. Come on, let's do imagination. Here's your friend back here. Help! Here's your friend. Mama! So we're going to draw. Maybe today, maybe we'll draw little teddy bears. Maybe today, maybe we'll draw dolphins jumping. Woo! Maybe we'll draw marshmallows parachuting. Whoa! Marshmallows. Maybe we'll draw penguins! Penguins floating by. Put your hand on your head. Stretch. We're going to stretch your ideas. So here's your paper. You all have four squares. You see, I'm from Texas. I say y'all. Okay, you all have four territories, right? So let's see here. We're going to start in square number one up here, and you guys can draw with me. Who's that? Who's that handsome devil? There's me right there. Oh, look at, I'm holding my Emmy. How modest of me. Now, right here, circle this. There's 12 words I'm going to be talking about today. These words have been around for 500 years. So I didn't invent these words. These words have been around for five centuries. Someone say, ooh. So if you learn these words, you can draw anything in 3D. That's how you really get pencil power. Someone say, pencil power. That's what we're going to develop. So, in the first word, in our very, very first word, I'm going to just change this camera just a bit so I can draw. I'm going to draw right here in square number one. Put two dots. So, to start with, let's Let's go back in time. Let's go back to the time of way back in time. Let's go back to the time of breakfast. Let's go back 20 minutes, right? You thought I was going to say go back to the land of dinosaurs, huh? We're going to go back to, we're going to draw a big breakfast ball. So put two dots, all right? Put two dots, just like that. Wait, down here. Put your name down here. Here, I'm going to put my name. My name is Mr. Cool. My name is Mr. Beard. My name is Mr. Mark here. Hey, now right here. So we have four territories and we're going to draw here. So you have two dots. So are you ready? Put your pencil over here. And we're going to draw the four shortened circles. So take your pencil and draw a four shortened circle. That's one of those 12 very important words. Remember, if you learn these words, you can draw anything in 3D. Take your thumb and go, oh, yeah. So here we are. We're on our path of creative discovery. So we drew a skinny four shortened circle. So from here, let's draw a bowl. Look at your neighbor and say, hey, nice dots. Look at your other neighbor and say, nice cereal bowl. Look at your drawing and go, ooh la la. You kids, you are so smart. Look at that. Is that funny or is that creepy? doesn't everybody have Einstein's face floating through their Facebook Live? Oh my goodness. Penguins! Anybody say pencil power. All right, remember, it's all about pencil power. Now, to make your drawing 3D, you really need to understand shadow and shading. So I'm going to put the light over here, our light, see? I'll do it in a second. I'm going to put a window up here. So what we're going to do is, just to anchor our drawing, let's put a shadow. Can you guys do that? Put a shadow down here. Ooh, I love it. Someone say shadow. Doesn't that look great? Put that shadow. Now, we could take this. We could put your hand on your head real quick. Put your hand on your head. Stretch your ideas. We can stretch. We can turn this into a clam under the ocean. We could turn this into a flying saucer. We could turn this into an egg hatching, a little chicken climbing out, or a little dinosaur. This is the start of many, many cool ideas. Now, way back here, this is an important word. This is called horizon. That's a background. So look at this, a few lines, and we already are creating this illusion of near and far, of depth. Can you say depth without spitting? Depth. See, this is close, and this is deeper. See, take your pencil and go, abracadabra. See, it's like a magic wand, see, and you're making a visual magic. All right, let's put some cereal in the bowl. Oh, yeah. Let's look at that, put some cereal in the bowl. And I don't know, I think you need some more cereal. More! And your mom looked over, honey, what are you doing? It's okay, Mumsy Poo. More! Honey, slow down, you're gonna hurt yourself. It's okay, Mumsy Poo. I must have more. Honey, why are you talking like that? You're freaking me out. More. Look at this. You turn like little breakfast monsters. Good morning, Mom. Feed me. Look at this. Look at all your... There's your cereal. I love the extra ideas. Wait. I got an idea. Here, where's my... Here you go. Here, this is my prop. Take your finger. Hold your finger up and go, aha. I got it, Greg. Take your finger and go, aha. I got it. I got an idea. My little light bulb went off. I have an idea. Let's have the cereal floating up into space. Yeah. Yeah, look at the cereal's defying gravity. It's a bird. It's a plane. It's Super Cheerio. See a little story? You're telling a story here, see? You're telling a story with your drawing. You're an author illustrator. Take your hand and go, oh, yeah. All right, so here we go. Now, let's identify for the viewers of your story. Let's put a window right here. See, I love adding the detail. Isn't that neat, little detail there? put a window. And then it, now some people put the, you know, the cross beams in here for the window panes. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to just have a big picture window. In fact, I'm going to put a frame around my window. See, I'm going to put a little frame here. That looked nice. And then, way over here, okay, so let's move this down here. Now, way up here, let's put, here's the sun. We have to identify, where's the light? The light's up here, see? Light's coming down. That's, so we're going to add some shading down over on this side, all right? We're going to add some shading over here. So, what I'll do, take this and tilt that down just a bit there. Let's see if I can get it right. I'm going to zoom in so you can see the detail. Oh, yeah. Someone say, ooh, la, la. All right, now take this. Sun's up here, so let's shade. Take your pencil and shade it. This is, now you have those stompies. Miss Horn, can I get a stompy? I don't have one up here. You can, you guys have, you have your little paper stompies. Do you have any extras? I think I have an old, good. Ooh, you got the nice stompies. Look at this. You guys, this is, I can't, see this? This is really nice. I can't tell you the last school that had stompies for their students, so this is great. Mrs. Horn, nice work. You hit it out of the ballpark today. These are blenders, you guys. You're going to use these to mush your drawing. So take your stompy, watch what you do. You have to put a layer of shading first. Take your pencil, put a layer of shading first. Shade, 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 shade. And then take your pencil. Now watch this. You're going to just, this is your stomping. Just going to blend it just a bit. Just, it's a little mushy. See, just mush it just a bit here. See that? It'll just mush it just a little bit. You can use your finger too. Your finger works. Now, I know you want to do this. Don't take your, don't take the musher and go. Don't go, yahoo! Now, this is called a stompy. Say, stompy. See, this is, say, I love my stompy. So, this doesn't do anything by itself. It's like a paintbrush. It's like you're painting. But you have to have paint first. You have to have pencil first. So, take your pencil, shade a little bit inside the bowl, and then let's take our blender. Now, the reason we're doing this, it's a round object. And so, when you're shading a round object, you're going to blend it. Sun's up here, so let's blend. See that? Blend, blend, blend. See, now watch this. I'm going to take this. You can take your stomping. You can put a little bit of value on the outside, too. I'm going to rub it over here. I'm going to put a little bit of darkness outside my window. That kind of makes that window pop out. All right, what other details can we add? Details, details, details. Take your finger. Take your finger and go, aha! What other ideas, sparks are going over there? Let's draw here. This is you. You're in the window. You're looking out. Oh, yeah. There. Who's that? This is little Bobby. Here's Bobby right here. There's Bobby. And then here's Patricia. She's looking over here. Hey, Bobby. Bobby, 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 get off my foot, Bobby. So here's Bobby, here's Patricia, and then over here, here's Elliot. He's looking over. Hey, look at that cereal. Whoa! Open the door. Let us in. And what else? Oh, look at all these ideas. Now, this is called overlapping. See, overlapping. Isn't that cool? And then over here, all right, so here's Bobby, here's Patricia, here's Elliot. Here, over here, here's, this is Beatrice. There's Beatrice right there. How come we're bald? How come we don't have any hair? Look at our little bald friends. I want some hair. Hair! Take your hand and go, ooh la la. See, now the fun part is adding your own ideas to the drawing, all right? All right, so I want to, let's hold up your drawing to show the world your drawing. You guys ready? And so here we are. Okay, hold up your drawing. Let me see. There's the kindergarten and the first grade, second graders, and the third and the fourth graders. Awesome first drawing. Art Attack. Look at Tony on Facebook said Art Attack. And Miss Conchita. Miss Conchita said Art Attack. All right, well, let's keep going. Square number two, we're going to be drawing. Let's keep going for a whole four drawings. So here we go. Square number two. You guys ready? Someone say pencil power. All right, square number next square. Here's what I'm going to do here. Square number two right there. Let me zoom this in. Okay, now for the next drawing, let's see. We can go with the ocean. We can draw dolphins and fish and sharks. We can draw. You guys are so smart. I think. Oh, look! We can draw a picture. I love you. Yes, I love you. Yes, I do. How about drawing a picture of my sister? Where's my bagel? Where's my bagel? I got it. Let's draw a dinosaur. Put two dots far apart. Let's draw a little baby dinosaur. Put two dots far apart. Two dots far apart. And then we're going to put a foreshortened circle. We're going to draw this really cool looking dinosaur. I'm going to move that up just a bit. So draw the foreshortened circle. Now we're going to use that same shape we just learned, and we're going to build on it, okay? We're going to add more detail. Someone say detail, detail, detail. All right, so we're going to use that same shape. Let's go ahead and build it, and we'll add more to it, add more to it, add more to it. The learning process is so fun. You learn a skill, and then you add on to it, and you get more skilled, and you get more ideas that you can add. Now, let's take this, and let's pop it open. Watch this. From this dot, I'm going to put a dot right here. I'm going to repeat that nice foreshortened circle. That's one of those words of drawing. Those words are 500 years old, remember? Remember these words right here on your paper? We used foreshortening. We put a check here. We used shading. Look at, we used shadow already, our first drawing. We used horizon. We used overlapping. Wow, look at that. Someone say, ooh la la. All these words and vocabulary, you guys, you're rocking. Okay, now, drop, pop it open. Pop goes the drawing. Someone say, pop goes the picture. Oh, you guys, someone say, pop. Pop, pop, pop. Look, it's popping out. This is the visual illusion. Let's draw the dinosaur egg hatching here. Oh, it looks like Pac-Man. Doesn't that kind of look like Pac-Man? Going around, blah, 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 blah. See, all these ideas, these are, take your finger and go, aha! All these ideas. Okay, let's draw the dinosaur's face. He's looking around, looking for adventure. So remember, you're the author illustrators. You're the movie director for your movie you're creating. These are your storyboards. You woke up, you had breakfast, you invited your friends over, and they're screaming, let us in! And you went outside and you met the little dinosaur baby. Mom, the dinosaur's hungry. Here, draw the neck. Now watch, this is going to taper. It's thin here. It gets thicker toward the shoulders. Now, right now, the dinosaur is behind. It's behind the egg. I want to put him inside, so let's overlap. You see that? Tuck him in. Overlap. See, go inside. Does that make sense? Give me a thumbs up if you're with me. Okay, you guys out there on Facebook, give me a thumbs up if that makes sense. See, you were overlapping right here. See, out there on, getting some thumbs up out there. All right, now, okay. Oh, look at that, Mr. Joshua Templeton in Houston, Texas, a fireman in Houston. He's with the firemen down there, and they're drawing with you guys. Can you say hi, firemen? Isn't that cool? He's drawing little dinosaurs in the firehouse. Well, thank you guys for keeping us safe. All right, now put the near eye here, and then way back here. This is size. Now watch this. Okay, here, see this? This is size. This is larger. Oh, there's a thumbs up. Cool, cool, cool. Here, this is smaller. See that? This is larger. Oh, that's looking cool. Now, I used the same thing when I drew the marshmallow parachuting in here. Shh, marshmallow. You see how that near eye is larger? See that? The near eye is larger and the back eye is smaller. That'll help make your drawing look. Look at my ninja banana. Hi-ya! But you see how the near eye here is larger than the far eye? Near things are larger. Look at my little minion guys here. See this? See my little minions? See how this eye is larger and this eye is smaller? And the near eye is larger and this eye is smaller. See, near things are larger. Let me see if I can show you. Let's show you another one that I drew here. Let me see here. Now, let me show you these sharks. Look at these sharks. See the sharks here? You see? The near part of the shark is larger and things get smaller as it goes away, right? Look, the nose is larger and things get smaller. Someone say size. So that's what we're doing. Even with a little detail, little tiny detail like the eye, just little tiny details like that make all the difference. Let's put a shadow back here. Shadow. So that's a great word too. Someone say shadow. Shadow. I love it. Looking cool. Let's take this. And then... I can't believe I just drew hair on a dinosaur. Look, I drew hair in the window. I drew hair on the dinosaur. Oh, wait. I got an idea. Take your finger and go, aha! I got an idea. Let's take a look at his hair. He's all edgy. Look. See that? Look, his hair. He needs a haircut. He needs a haircut. Isn't that funny? All right, now, this is texture. Another great word, texture. So what we'll do is let's add texture. Let me here. Here's darken it. Let's add some texture. Put some dots down here. Let's put this nestled into a bunch of grass in your backyard. So put some lawn from the dot. Put texture. Texture is a great word. Someone say texture. All right. Texture, like if you're drawing a house, the roof would be shingles or slate or a tree. If you're drawing a tree, you would draw the wood grain, the trunk, the leaves. Someone say texture. See, we're adding that grass to the bottom. And I hope you guys out there in internet world, out there in Facebook world, I hope you're drawing with us too. Put the texture. Texture. That looks cool. Love it. All right, now let's shade it. Let's have the sun way up here. We got to know where the light is. The sun's up here. There's the sun. Sun's coming down from up here. So now we're going to add. Here's the sun's up here coming down. So let's, sun's up here. Let's shade opposite. See this? See, shade opposite. We're not using the stompy yet. That's just a musher. This is a blender. We'll use that in just a second. It's dark here, and it's going to get lighter and lighter as you go out. See this? Isn't that fun? Someone say, ooh, this is fun. All right, looking cool. Now, while I'm drawing this right here, I'm going to shade down here. Now, Mrs. Horn, can you pick three kids to come up here to the stage. I want to put them on camera to show their drawings to everybody. Now, here's the age. Ready, Mrs. Horn? We're going to start with, give me three fifth graders, please. And now you guys, before you come up, fifth graders, look, before she's going to choose you, but before you come up, shade inside right here. Let's finish this drawing. But I want to show, after we finish this drawing, don't come up yet. Just stay there. We just wait, finish the drawing. Here's shade inside. And then look, we got to shade the neck. See, everywhere that the sun is, we're going to shade opposite, see? Everywhere the sun is, we're shading opposite. Isn't that wonderful? Shade. Love it. Isn't this cool? Someone say, ah, this is cool. Take that finger and go, aha! Someone say, eureka! Someone say, where's my bagel? I have no idea where that came from, but it's pretty funny. All right, now sun's up here. Shade inside. Oh, you guys are going to be these great storyboarders and artists, illustrators, directors, digital game designers, toy designers, architects, engineers. Take your pencil or your stompy. Now watch. Let's take the stompy. Now use the end that the more you use it, see, the more pencil gets on here, the better. See, these new ones don't blend very well, but I'm just going to very lightly, don't push too hard, just mush it a little bit like this. See that? Now, this one does not blend. You got to push a little bit harder. Okay, there we go. There we go. Just kind of smoothing it out. Just a little blender, see? Teachers, is it working for you, teachers out here? Thumbs up, teachers, or down? Okay, good. So you got to kind of figure it out, mush it. It's just a little painter thing. Okay, where's my students? Where's the my 3 fifth graders are going to come up here and show us your cereal bowl, and you're going to show us your dinosaur egg. Where they'll get these thumbs up. I'm getting so many thumbs up here. We have over 14,000 people watching us. I'm just joking. We have 14. Okay, here, come up here. Oh, wait. I'm going to put you guys on camera. Here you are. Here they are. Come stand up right here. Okay, stand right here. Okay, wait. Okay, there you are. Stay, just line up right here. All right. Oh, you guys look good. Okay, ready? All right. Now, wait. I've got to get you guys on here, too. All right, so here's your, what's your name? Okay, look at her drawings. Aren't they great? And what's your name? All right. Okay. And can you guys move down so I can get you on here, too? Look at these drawings. Those are great. What's your name? Well, you did it. Can you guys say fantastic? Wait, you guys, look at Facebook Live. Give them some hearts. See the hearts going across here? That's great. All right. Well, good job, you guys. Everybody out there, give me a thumbs up if you're keeping up with me. Go back to your seat. Thumbs up. Hold up your drawings so I can show the world your drawings. Hold the world. And here. There you are. Oh, my goodness. You guys are doing great. Look at. All right. Oh, you guys got to see. Look at the screen. Look at all those hearts going by. Look at that. Look at all those hearts. Isn't that great? They love you. They love you. All right, let's go. Square number 3. Let's go on. Push on. Great stories. Good job, fifth graders. We're going to have a couple fourth graders next, and we'll have some third graders and first graders and kindergartners. Now, square number 3. Where are we going to go? Let's, on this one, I'm thinking, let's go into space. Let's draw a spaceship. All right, now for this one, well, wait, let me think. I think... Let's draw. We have to do a spaceship. Okay, put 2 dots straight across. Wait, well, okay, spaceship. Okay, 2 dots straight across from each other. Now on this spaceship, we're gonna do a little bit different thing because we did 2 foreshortened circles in a row. So let's make a foreshortened box. We'll draw like this. You made a spaceship out of a cardboard box in your room. This is inspired by one of my favorite comic artists. His name is Bill Watterson. He did a bunch of many, many books and many comic strips called Calvin and Hobbes. And Bill Watterson, one of my all-time illustration heroes. And Calvin made spaceships out of cardboard boxes and would travel all over the history and world and imagination. So let's do a little box. Okay, so you have 2 dots far apart. Look at your neighbor and say, nice dots. Okay, hold up your drawing. Let me see your dots. I got to see it. Let me see. Show me. Excellent. And, okay, put them down. Now, you have 2 in the middle close together. So watch what we're going to do. Start at the top dot, connect it. Take your pencil here. Take your pencil, turn the corner. Shh. Now, careful. Don't slip. Don't go, Mommy. Turn the corner. Shh. Stay in control of the pencil. Careful. Easy. Don't go, Papa. Turn the corner. Shh. See? All right, now show me. Let me see. Show me. Let me see it. Oh, yeah. You got it. Someone say, I got it. Awesome. All right, we're going to draw the space box. Okay, cardboard box, and you're going to turn it with your imagination to a really cool flying spaceship. How awesome is that? Now, don't go straight across. We're going to go uphill to the right. All right, and then go uphill to the left. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to open this cardboard box up. Let's open the flaps. So here's one flap over here. So draw one edge of the cardboard box. Now this one is actually a lesson in my book here. Now I'm going to leave this in your library so you guys will be able to check this out. Here's one of my books. I've written 14 books. I have over a million. Right here it says 500,000. I have over a million now in print. Can someone say, oh, how impressive? Oh, very cool. And I want you guys to use this book, okay? If I leave it in your library, are you going to use it? Raise your hand if you'll use it if I leave it for you guys to check out. okay, I'll sign it for you guys and everything. There's all kinds of good two-point perspective, one-point perspective lessons. And look at the tree lesson. That looked fun. Someone say, ooh, tree. See the trees? Now, oh, moon craters. That look cool. Someone say, craters. That's so cool. Now, I was going to show you is this box lesson. It's way up at the front. Ooh, little koala bears. Oh, look, little fluffy koala bear. Look, he's so cute. Yes, he is. Now, here's, look, we're going to draw this right here. Doesn't look cool? That one right there? Someone say, ooh, la, la. But we're going to take this box, and we're going to turn it into a spaceship, all right? So, stretching our ideas, take that finger and go, aha! All right, so let's zoom this in. All right, so we draw it. Now, following the guideline, following the lines you've drawn before, draw that line. And I'm going to erase that back flap. See that? Erase that. And I'm going to draw this line. It's okay to erase to detail it in. Looking cool. Middle line's a little bit lower. And this one's higher. So go uphill here. This is called direction northeast. Then I use my eraser to kind of get that detail. So we're going to clear that up. Doesn't that look cool? Does that look great? Someone say, I got it. Now, inside, we forgot to put the thickness line. Put that little thickness line. We're going to shade this inside. I want to erase this one a little bit more over here. A little bit more over here. This is so cool. Hey, Gregory Dolbeck, I've been enjoying all of your dragons, Gregory, on Facebook. You've been drawing a lot of dragons lately. That's awesome. Here, let's pop this flap open over here. Give me thumbs up, kids. You with me? Thumbs up, thumbs medium. Two thumbs up, yeah. Take your hand and go, oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, so let's pop it open now. Remember, you're the author illustrator. This is your creation. So where is your imagination going to take you? We started with our cereal bowl, took off, and we have a dinosaur. It's like we went back into time. Now we're jumping into a cardboard box and we're going to travel. Where are we going to travel? Are we going to go to the land of like Vikings and knights of the round table? Are we going to go to ancient Egypt? Here, draw the top flap. Are we going to land on the moon? Are we going to go into the water? All right, so take your pencil. Here we go. Now, up here, let's put, you're going to be you're a spaceship traveler here. So here's your face. And I'm going to tuck you inside here. You climbed in the box. Okay, we are ready for liftoff. Power level, check. Wing flaps, check. Pop-Tart supply, check. So here you are. Like you invited your friends. Okay, so here's Bob. Say hi, Bob. There's Bob. All right, here's... And you invited Sally. Here's Sally. Look at, she's very tall. Here's Sally. Sally's one of your taller friends. And then you invited Harold. And look at Harold's kind of small. You see his Harold's forehead. Harold's kind of short. There's Harold. So here's your friends. Now here you are here. Now see. You got your goggles on, see? You have these, it's like sunglasses. So you're ready. You're looking cool. Whoa, mama! And Sally's going, get your hair out of my face! Look at this, and here's Sally. Here's Sally. Faster! Faster! Here's Harold down here. Slow down! Look at all the eyes. These guys are looking cool. And who's this over here? I forgot. Who's that? Is that Bob? Here's Bob. Bob's looking around going, oh, how beautiful. Look. Look at the world. It's so blue. Look at that. Now, here's Bob. Bob's going, oh, no. I lost my sunglasses. Oh, no, my sunglasses. Faster! Take your finger and go, aha! So many ideas. What are you going to... Maybe since you're in space, maybe you saw marshmallows floating by. You know, marshmallows. All right, so the sun's up here. Let's identify where's the light. Where's the light coming from? The sun's up here. So we're going to shade opposite. The sun's coming up here, so take your pencil. Now, on this one, we're not going to use the stompy. I'm going to forego the stompy. I use this one mostly for round, curving objects. The sun's up here coming down. So we're going to shade under the flap. We're going to shade opposite on the left side. Someone say shade, 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 shade. Pop goes the drawing. And then now watch this. I'm going to put a little shadow under that flap right there. Can you put a little bit, little shadow under there? Maybe a little bit of shadow. A little bit of shadow under there. That looks kind of cool, huh? And, oh, this is cool. Maybe a little darker shadow under here. Where are you guys going to travel with pencil power? Where are you going to go? Raise your hand if you want to travel to ancient Egypt. Who wants to go under the ocean? Who wants to land on the moon? Who wants to travel to the space station? Oh, there's so many ideas. Here, down here, let's draw. Here, this is the horizon line. This is your, that's your lawn. That's your front lawn right here. And you're flying. Look at, put a, underneath here we'll put a shadow. You're hovering. See? You put a shadow. Isn't that cool? See how it looks like it's hovering? Do you love it? Someone say, love it. I love that. I love that shadow. And then, let me see here, down here, going. Oh, put some action lines. Actually, you know what? I'm going to put a little jet rocket here. Someone say, love it. Oh, this is cool. All right, put your hand on your head. Stretch your ideas. More detail. Maybe we'll put some Cheerio power. Go, Cheerio power. Looking cool. Cheerio power. Isn't that wonderful? All right. Looking cool. Now, way back here, put some action lines. And put some action lines. Pencils up on your head. Put your pencils up on your head and say, pencil power. Hey! Draw, 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 draw. The action line's taken off. Looking cool. Now, you know what we could do? Here, way down here, just put a picture of, what's your name in the green? What's your name? Logan. Help me, Mom. Okay, honey pie. Okay, I can't hear. So here she is. She's first grader in green, and she missed the bus here. Wait! Look at, she missed the bus. Here she is. Here she is. Wait, wait! I missed it. Wait! There she is. She's running. Here, her hair is flying. Wait! You forgot your sandwich. Wait! Here, put a shadow under her. Look at, she's running, chasing the bus. And then draw the little puff clouds here. It's taking off. Oh, I love it, love it, love it. All right. Mrs. Horn, can you get a couple third graders and 2 fourth graders? Let's get 4 students up here. And let's see their artwork. So here she is. She's getting some students. All right, guys. Here they come. We got a couple of third graders and fourth graders coming up here. This is cool. Hey, David. David's watching from Houston, Texas. Come on up, guys. We're going to see you up here on stage. And see your work. Line up along here. Let's get you first. Okay. Here, everybody get in line behind him. Get in line behind him. And nice job. Say hi to the world.
Hi.
And what's your name? And what's your name? Okay, put your drawing under your chin. There, right under your chin. Step as close as you can. And look at all the happy faces. Okay, go on, get out of here. You're amazing. Okay, go on, shoot. Go back to your seat. Go on, back to your seat. Okay, come here. Let me see yours. Put your drawing under your chin. Look at these, you guys. Look at all the happy faces you're getting. Look at. Okay, look at. See all those? See all the hearts? See they're going across the screen? Isn't that great? Okay, go on. You did great. Let's see you. Look at her. She's so, look at all the happy faces. What's your name?
Mary Kay.
Oh, my goodness. We're ready for another one. Go on, get out of here. You're amazing. And what's your name?
Mary
And let me see your drawings. Oh, look at that. These are awesome. Okay, go on. Look at this. Look at all the happy faces. They're going crazy. Look at all those happy faces. What's your name? Okay, let me see your drawing. Oh, my goodness. These are great. All right, go on. You're amazing. All right, look at the little... Oh, your hair's alive! Wow, those are great. All right, go on. Get out of here. Good job. Can you guys say nice work? Ooh, la, la. Well, we have time for one more drawing. One more. First of all, everybody show everybody your drawing. Put, hold your drawing up. And look at this. You guys, someone say awesome. Isn't that a great shot? I love it. I love it. I love it. All right. Okay, I'm proud of you. I'm proud of you. Oh, oh, coffee break. Wait, wait. Why are you staring at me? Stop it. You're freaking me out. Mom, the kids are staring at me. Let's go. Someone say pencil power. Where's mine? Where, here it is. Pencil power. Shh. You like my high-tech puppets? You guys can make animated movies, you know this? I learned this from Brandon Ray. He does animations for Disney and for music rock stars. He does paper animations. He does backgrounds. And he does a background, then he takes paper puppets and goes like this. It's so cool. Isn't that fun? And you guys can video with your parents' phone with their permission. All right, next square. On YouTube, if you guys... Hey, how many of you want to do another drawing with me? Raise your hand. How many of you want to draw with me, say, for 100 more lessons? Well, tell you what. Tell you what. With your parents' permission, this is with your parents' permission, I want you to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Okay, now, I have 1,200,000 views on it right now. My goal is to get 10 million views. I want you guys to watch my lessons. I put 100 lessons on there. Plus, I put a lot of my drawings you see on the wall back here. I put a camera and I video it and I time-lapse. So you can see me actually drawing a lot of these up here. That's really neat. So, with your parents' permission, I don't want you anywhere near your computer internet without your parents' permission. Say yes, sir. With your parents' permission, you guys subscribe to YouTube, Mark Kistler, my YouTube site, and you can do more drawings with me. I'm going to post this on YouTube, the video we're making right now. Now, so you'll be able to do this again. Here, up here, square number next square. Let's draw a robot. Let's draw a robot. Two dots. Now, I don't have a clock or a watch, Mrs. Horn. What time? I mean, how much? Just give me how many?
10:15. You have about
10
more minutes.
How much? 10?
10.
Cool, cool. So we can go for another hour. Is that right? You guys want to draw for another hour? Hey, how about, why don't we, let's just take the whole day. Yay. All my viewers just dropped off. All right. Here, put your finger in the middle. We're going to draw another 4 short 10 square. I love it. Put your finger right here in the middle. We're going to draw a cool robot. You're going to love this. Look at all their hearts are going crazy. Everybody on Facebook's going, yeah, let's take the whole day. Let's draw. Woo. And then Amy Boyce says, come to Iowa, Mr. Kistler. Now, I would love to go. I went to Dubuque, right? Is that Dubuque? I went to Dubuque, Iowa. That was last year. The Field of Dreams. If you draw it, they will come. Here, take your pencil. We're going to put a 4 short 10 square. Shoo. Get ready. Turn the corner. Shoo. Get ready. Turn the corner. Get ready. We're going to draw the 4 short 10 square. Shoo. Get ready. 4 short 10 square. And Judy up here says, yay. You can't say yay. Yay. Look at, doesn't that look like my sister? That looks just like my sister. Penguins! We should draw the robot chasing a penguin. That's what we should. We should draw the robot chasing a penguin while they fly in a spaceship with marshmallows. Yeah. Yeah, I see it. I get to take your finger ideas. Aha! Oh, my goodness. We are on our imagination. We're in the zone. Now, go uphill here. Turn the corner. This is longer. That's placement. Near things are lower. Near things are lower. That makes it the illusion of 3D. Pop goes the drawing. All right, now up here. Look at. Let's put here. Draw the neck here. There's her neck. Looking cool. And so there's a little robot. Very simple. Now look at. Here's some variations of robot. I did this at a school last week. Look at this robot guy. Isn't that cool? Is that great? Now and then, here I'll show you a couple other robots. Here's some variations. Now these are on my YouTube lesson. I did that robot, and then look at this. Someone say variation. So you add your own ideas, and then look at we change it again. Someone say variety. See, having a little, and then did you know that robots' best friends are bunny rabbits? Is that bad if I laugh at my own jokes? Is that bad if I toot my own horn? Someone say awesome! Now, you see this drawing I did right here? The lesson that I wanted to teach you on this one is how important it is to look at different drawings that you enjoy and love and copy them and trace them and study them. This is a Dr. Seuss-inspired drawing. This was inspired the book from Dr. Seuss called Oh, the Places You'll Go. Raise your hand if you love Dr. Seuss books. All right. Well, instead of just looking at the pictures now, I want you to draw them. I want you to study them and look at them and trace them. I probably traced 1,000 Dr. Seuss pictures. So this was, I did this drawing as a salute to celebrate Theodore Geisel's imagination, Dr. Seuss's imagination. Well, let's go on. Look at little teddy bear. Look at, I love you. Yes, I do. Yes, I do. All right. Let's draw the near eye. The near eye is larger. The near eye is larger. Does anybody here have a brother? The back eye is smaller. Does anybody here have a brother or sister in the 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th grade? Upper grades here at the school, here at this school? Okay. Well, we're going to be drawing with them and starting in about 10 minutes. We're going to have another group in here for an hour, right? They'll put thickness on the eye. So if you want to draw more, have your older brother and sister show you their drawings. We're going to do totally different drawings with them, a little more advanced. So they, and then you can show them your drawings. That sound like a good idea tonight? And you can have your parents draw with your mom and your papa. Papa. Hey, papa, come draw. Papa. You ever call your dad papa? I used to try to get all my kids to call me papa because I think it's cool. They never would. No, I don't want to do that. You're dead. No, I'm papa. Papa. Okay, go home for today. All day today you have to say papa. Yeah, that'll be great. He'll love that. Seriously. He'll thank me. All right, look at the eyes. He's cool. Now the sun. Let's put the sun over here. I'm going to keep the sun on the right side. Sun's papa. This robot's looking around. Where's my papa? Should I put a scary mouth, like fangs? Like vampire robot? Okay, look. He's looking super scary. Look. Are you scared? Mrs. Horn's scared. I can see she's scared. Look at, she's all squealing down there. Oh, terrifying. Look at everybody online right here. They're all freaking out. All right, here, the sun's coming down, so let's shade the side. Hey, we have Fidel Trevino Jr. drawing with us. Everybody say, hey, Fidel. That's awesome getting all you to draw with us. All right, Mrs. Horn, art teacher extraordinaire. I'm going to call you Queen Art. Can you pick a couple of drawings? Pick a first grader, pick a kindergartner, pick a second grader, pick a third grader. Pick grades we haven't had up here. I want to see them. I need three. Get three students if you would. Three. Mm-hmm. Okay, here's shade. Now we're going to add some more extras here. Put a dot. We're going to add some more extras. I'm going to put an antenna on this robot. I want the robot to be able to communicate with the mother's spaceship. Come on up, honey. Come on. Here she comes. Our genius artist. Dun, da, da. Okay, hold on a second here. Wait. Okay, stand right there. Put your drawing. Stand right next to the table. Put your drawing under your chin. Get in one line behind her. And wait a minute. I'm going to get this so the whole world can see you. All right. See, here's my camera. Okay, here it is. Oh, there she is. Hi. So, see, I'm going to show them. Look at all this. Yeah, watch what happens. I show you, and then look at all the happy faces. Look at all the hearts. Do you see all the hearts going crazy? Is that cute? They love you. They love you. You're famous. Okay, get out of here. Okay. All right, here. Look at you. You're, oh, my gosh, you're wonderful. Look at all the happy faces. Look, they're going crazy. All right, you're so great. All right, go on. Get out of here. Okay, come here. Look at her. Okay, excellent, excellent. Okay, go on. Good job. Let me see yours. Oh, my goodness. Look at these. I need to get, can I please get three teachers up here right away? Come here, three teachers. Okay, go on, guys. That's good. Go on. Good job. Go on. Okay, come here. Okay, come on, teachers. Teachers, look how quickly they're responding. Teachers, come on, be brave. Okay, here, come here. Good. All right, go on, get out of here. You're awesome. Okay, let me see yours. Okay, go sit down. Go sit down. Okay, come here, guys. Come here. Okay, look at you. Oh, my gosh. Look at that, you guys. Here, I got to show you a drawing. Here, come here. Look at his drawing. Are you? What grade are you in? That's awesome. Okay, go on. All right. Oh, my gosh. Hey, nice haircut. Okay, here. Okay, go on. Go sit down. All right. And happy. Okay, go sit down. Awesome job. Teachers! Come on up here, dear. How are you? Look at my teachers. What grade do you teach, ma'am?
Third
grade. Thank you for sharing that. And what grade do you teach, ma'am? Kindergarten teachers. I love you. All right, go on. Sit down. Another teacher. Okay, we need more teachers. Every teacher. Come here. Come here. Excellent. I need more teachers. More teachers. Come on, teachers. Come on. Come on. Here, they're being shy. Come on. Oh, that's awesome. Okay. Here, I'll put you on there. So put it up to your chin. Oh, I'm proud of you. Go on. Get out of here. You're awesome. What grade do you teach, ma'am? Everybody put you on the camera. Can you lower it a little bit? There. Awesome. Thank you, dear. Hi, look at things. People online are going crazy.
Hi, Mom.
Is she online right now watching?
I hope so.
Here, wait. Let me see. Those are fantastic. Hey, those are better than mine. Wait, I'm threatened. Okay. Hi, dear. What grade do you teach? Let me see here. Okay, let me put you on happy screen. Can you go get your face on the screen? There you go. Get out of here. You're awesome. Oh, my goodness gracious. Oh, these are fantastic. What grade do you teach? Kindergarten, thank you. Let me see your drawings. Hi. Oh, thank you, teachers. You guys are such good sports. Well, everybody online, can you wave to everybody online, you guys? Wave. And thank you all for joining us. And thank you, guys. We'll see you. I'm going to do another program in 10 minutes. Hey, guys. Way to go. I'm proud of you. Raise your hand if you had fun. Raise your hand if you had fun. Raise your hand if you promise me that you'll draw a little bit every day. A little bit every day. Now remember, tonight, I'm invited at 6:30, all you and your parents to come back, and we're going to do a whole different drawing lesson. Does anybody want to come back tonight and draw? I hope you do. Do they need to bring paper and pencil? I mean, do they tonight, or you'll have it here? Okay. All right. Do you want to collect the pencils now, Mrs. Horn? No, I mean, right now, do you want to collect them? Teachers, kids, to hold your pencils, erasers up, and look at your teachers. They're going to tell you exactly what to do. Follow your teachers.